Pizarro's expedition attained a certain success. Panama and its governor were very surprised to see the voyagers, having long thought Pizarro and his associates dead. Facing the governor's opposition in plotting a new expedition, Pizarro decided to appeal to the king instead. The members of the triumvirate collected money for their trip, and, taking with them some gifts from Tumbes, Pizarro sailed to Spain to see Charles V. Having recruited a considerable force of men, Pizarro returned to Panama to be welcomed coldly by Almagro and Ruiz. It appeared to them that instead of keeping to their agreement of assured equality in both profits and glory, Pizarro had taken all the profits for himself. It was a long time before the arguing conquerors could be pacified. In January 1531, Pizarro set off for the third time with hundreds of soldiers to conquer Tahuantinsuyo. When he arrived at Tumbes, he found that somebody else had already been there. He discovered that the native inhabitants of the nearby Puna had assaulted Tumbes and left no stone unturned. His dreams of booty were shattered. Feeling that the explorers needed to rest, Pizarro moved further south to establish San Miguel, the first European city on Peruvian territory.